It's a clickbait video. Nah, it's real. It's still free for life. It's free trial for 12 months. Google has been offering free trial on cloud service since, I believe, 2014. Like Microsoft Azure and Amazon Web Service too. They are offering free trial as well. You can create and use a VPS for free without getting any charges until your credit expires. It looks complex, and it is, for starter, because there aren't any guidelines to follow. Therefore, I'll try to explain everything to you as a starter should know. It will be a lengthy video. What? Out of the three options here, Google Cloud Service is the most recommended option, simply because of the server available are not limited only to United States. And Google has the fastest server available. We will continue this explanation later. I guess there are videos out there already that teaches you how to install MetaTrader on a VPS but never told you how can you avoid automatic restart due to Windows update and so. So your automatic trading robot or expert advisor get resets as well. Anyway, let's start. So before registering a Google Cloud Service account, you are required a Gmail account and a credit card. Sorry, debit card don't work. Then have your web browser open. I'm using Opera, by the way, and I love it. Ha 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 ha. Anyway, go to google.com. On the search box, type Google Cloud. It seems it's appearing on the first result. Click it. You want to click Get Started for Free. Now, agree the terms and condition, otherwise. For the account type, select individual since you're not a business, corporations, organizations, or something else. And fill in all the necessary information. I'll be skipping this since it's not a difficult task. Then click the Start My Free Trial. Welcome, Ben, a random name. Thanks for signing up. Why not? It's free. Your free trial includes $300 in credits to spend over the next 12 months. If you run out of credit, don't worry, you will be billed, because to use Compute Engine, you are required to switch on the automatic billing. When credits run out, you have to manually close the billing account or delete the VPS. We will continue this later. Got it? So generally, we are using Google Cloud Service solely for VPS and maybe other virtual machines that are located on Compute Engine. Anyway, click the Go to Compute Engine. Compute Engine is getting ready. This may take a minute or more, generally 3 minutes. Done. Click Create. This is a free trial credit I was given, varies between local currency due to currency conversions. The region here is the server location. Select one that's nearest to your country, Singapore for me. You don't want to pick a server far from you simply because of the response rate. We call it ping rate, or latency if you like, will be higher. The ping rate to Google server was something like 20 ms. That was like 0.02 seconds per response between your computer and the Google server, which is like almost instant. It's by far the best server that could be found in the world. For zone, pick anyone, it doesn't matter. We have the machine type here. Generally, MetaTrader are enough to be powered with 1.7 GB memory. I do notice there are some expert advisor, some consume more RAM usage due to opening more chart and require more calculations, and therefore require a larger memory. Of course, the higher the spec you pick, the higher the cost it is. Look at the price here, and it has yet to account the Windows license fee. That will be double the price. On the boot disk option here, click Change. Instead of Debian, a nice operating system, we want to install Windows. On the operating system, click for the drop-down menu and click Windows Server. On version, click Windows Server 2012. You may try 2016 or 2019 if you like, but I usually pick the oldest version simply because of the compatible issues. You know, the... Yeah, that's what I mean. I forgot to record and show you the changes on the price estimation, so make sure to pay attention to that price estimation so you will get the idea estimate how long you will get charges before the credits run out. Oops, our server failed to launch. It's not supported on the free credit service. Now we have to enable the automatic building first. So click View Building Report. My building account, manage building account. My building account again. There's a word upgrade here and where your trial credit will list it as well. Click it. To be able to use the VPS, you are required to upgrade your account. It simply means enable automatic building. So you won't be charged until your free credits run out or expire, whichever comes first. Click upgrade. Bookmark this page if you will to constantly check if the free credits run out. Click on the notification button and click retry. The server will be prepared this time, so back to compute engine and click VM instance. Wait a few minutes and refresh the page. It should be show up now. This external IP here is your server's IP address. Copy it down. Then click instance 1. You have to create a password, so set Windows password. This is your username. Copy it down. Click set and wait. It takes a while. This is your VPS password. Copy it down. So you have the VPS ready and you have the login detail. Now you just need to connect it. I'm not sure about Mac user, but for Windows user, open start menu and type remote desktop connection. Open it. By default, when you connect it, you'll be entering a full screen mode. We don't want that, so click show options. Go to display tab. Adjust the display size you feel comfortable with. Some still prefer full screen. Back to general tab and paste your VPS login detail. Allow me to save credentials. Enter the password. Do not remember me if you are using a public computer. Don't ask me again for connection to this computer. Welcome to Windows Server 2012, provided for free by Google Cloud Server. Thank you, Google. Now, first you have to disable the IE enhanced security configurations. Otherwise, you are not allowed to use Internet Explorer to download other browser, Chrome. Now, I tried to download MetaTrader 4 from their official website. Instead, they gave me MetaTrader 5. So I download it on Wanda. Installing. There you go. That's the MetaTrader 4. You can install the expert advisor you want on this server without getting interrupted by disconnections or so. The next thing to do is to disable the Windows update to prevent like unnecessary restart. Now right-click the taskbar and open the task manager. Expand the menu by clicking More Details. Click Services. Sort by names on name. Yeah. There is this WUAUSERV which stands for Windows Update. Right click and stop service. Repeat again by going to Open Services. Look for Windows Update. Double-click Windows Update to get the Properties windows show up. On the Startup type, switch to Disable. Apply it and you're now safe from forceful restart. And do a double-confirm by going back to Task Manager, Services, and to see if Windows Update is stopped. Good. Good. The next thing we want to do is to log the IP address. Google Cloud Service tend to switch the VPS IP address when your machine is restarted. It's frustrating because whenever you're connecting back to your VPS, you're required to enter the same old long password and a newly created IP address over and over again. So back to Google Cloud Service, expand the tab menu from the left, search for VPC network, click external IP addresses, click ephemeral and switch it to static. Give a random name like ABC if you want to. Lastly, congrats for following this file with me. Everything is now done. So to connect back to the VPS, just open the start menu. Type remote desktop connection. Your safe VPS with its IP address will be listed here. Click it and voila! I believe you are able to configure the remaining stuff yourself, so I will leave it to you. This will be the end of the video. If you like this video, I appreciate very much a thumbs up and leave me a question on the comment if you have one. As a last reminder, do consistently check if the credit runs out. You may not want to pay the maintenance fee. If so, Google charge around 50-100% expensive than most VPS outside. But it's worth if you don't want your trades to get interrupted. Unlike other cheap VPS, they get disconnected very frequently. I will leave any misinformation on the description box if I miss one. Anyway, goodbye.